very very relaxed, very like that.
What would you remember his name?
I think he was very sure. Not too sure. But I think he was very sure.
And you said that there was another man there as well. Just the woman that turned her back and blackmailed him. And you said that he picked you up, he dragged you up by your arm.
He dragged me by the cuffs, the middle of the cuffs which my arm connected to. And he had me like my book, my head was face down, and my arms were like the middle of it. And like they just carried me with the cuffs to the back.
They did.
Yeah, him and his colleague.
So when was the first time you saw his colleague?
When they shut the van door. That's when I first saw my eyes crooked. When I actually spoke to him before leaving him back in the train.
When did you actually know he was there? So did he come up to the room at the back of the shop? They've taken you out. Can you tell me what happened on that journey from the room at the back to the van?
They just treated me inappropriately from being booked into detention to being interviewed. Mm-hmm. Just the whole... everything about them, their whole conduct is just wrong. It's just, they just treat me like they wanted to hurt me, properly hurt me, and they did.
And you said that you've never had any dealings with the officer before.
I don't know any of those police officers. I'm from South East London, I was born in the village. I don't know, PC kid.
And in the cage, you said that the officer, PC kid, you referred to
him. He saw me again, kid, yeah.
He said that you tried to spit on him.
He said I spat on him.
Right. And you said that you didn't.
No, I didn't.
And he grabbed you by both hands.
And he banged me on the cage. He banged my back and my chest onto the back of the hole.
And the other officers in custody were watching this.
Yeah, they watched him and everybody was just acting like we're not really here, this is not really happening. You know, we're just gonna abuse you for a little bit of dark money, playing house, you know. Just like that. It's like a game, really. Yeah, playing a game.
Is there anything else that you can think of that you wanted to?
When I went to be sentenced for the shoplifting incident, PC Kid and his colleague was there and the judge did not request me with the legal.
Did you have any dealings with them on that day?
Well, when I had to stand up in the dock and I had to give my evidence about and put my name and stuff, they were sat in the dock smiling when there wasn't a person to come to court. Seeing him, it actually reduced me to tears. Everything that he had done to me started to flash back in my head about what the family usually get years and the pain that he conflicted upon my body. I was not a human being, like I was not a female, like I was not someone's child, like I was not someone's mother, like I was not someone's brother or sister, the cousin, auntie, uncle. He abused me and everybody overlooked it. I've actually got scars on my body. I don't know how much it's going to cost to remove it. A laser treatment, but it's going to cost more. I've got a big scar on my back for that policeman, and I've got some bad memories. I've actually had to take counselling over. And he also broke my two ribs.
So you said you had two broken ribs, yeah, and this cut me back.
Mm-hmm.
Which you need 8 stitches for.
Mm-hmm.
into your face. You said on the right side of your face you've got a mark.
When he punched me in my head, it took skin off my face. And I had a big graze on the side of my temple when he punched me.
Did you have any other visible injuries after?
No, I took pictures of them. I had cuts on my foot, bruises on my face, just cuts all over where I was being thrown around. And my wrists were cut when he put the cuffs too tight. It actually took skin off and left the scar.
I'm just going to check, James, that I've covered everything, and then I'll come back to you, see if you want to add anything else. Okay, come on.
This is what grabs me. I didn't kick off. I didn't get aggressive. I didn't swear. I didn't shout. It's totally amazing. I can't believe it myself. He just went in. There was no question about it. He wasn't waiting around for me to be rude and cocky. He didn't wait around. He went holding my muscle. No way. He just went in.
And how long have you been in the room before this started?
Not even a minute. Not even a minute. As soon as he came in, he asked me my name, asked me for my ID. As soon as I reached out for the ID, he just switched and started acting like a cannibal. He just went in. I did not do anything to him for him to act this way, which was quiet, which was really, really odd. It was very, very odd for me, because normally, you know, I think that if I had assaulted him and he had claimed self-defense, then I'd understand. But I hadn't assaulted him. I haven't abused him mentally or physically, so he hasn't got any excuse for him to turn around and be an aggressive abuser towards me. He hasn't got any. There's no reason in the world for his behaviour that day. I had not done nothing to that man. I've never been arrested by him before. I've never seen him on the streets before. I don't know the man. All I know that when I was arrested, the way that he treated me was just appalling. It was just, there was no reason for it. So how many more people has he done that to? If he's just done that to me, and I haven't done anything to him, not a thing. I didn't shout any abuse at him. I didn't attempt to assault him. Nothing. You know, he just, I don't know what's wrong with him. I can't speak for his behaviour. I don't know.
Okay. I just wanted to see what your opinion was of that. I said, have you been treated in any way like that by any other police officers?
Yeah, I have, yeah. I'm lying, yeah, I have.
So what's the difference between how they treated you and how James...
I've been strip searched by men and women, cut into my groin with scissors, cut into my bra, left on the floor, nothing to eat, no phone call, no water, no toilet paper, no mattress, no cloth, no clothes on my back, no doctor, no nurse, just left. Nothing. It's not the first time that I've been in the
happens sometimes. This just happens, isn't it? This, what can I do? There's nothing I can do. I'm up against it. It's just me against them. And I ain't coming. So if they want to ill-treat me, they can ill-treat me, because what can I do? What can I do? There's nothing I can do about it, is there?
Well, you're doing this, and this is not. And I know it's been difficult for you.
Mm-hmm.
And I can see that you've got quite upset.
I get angry because I think to myself, I didn't do nothing to him, so it did not have any reason for him to act in that behaviour towards me.
Well, thank you so much for going through it again. I'm sorry if I've upset you in any way by asking some questions, but this is going to be your evidence to the court, okay? So we need to get it in as much detail as we could. Is there anything that you want to say?
No, there's nothing else I want to say.
Okay, alright, well the time is now, what's the time right there? The time is 14:35 on the 4th of September 2013.